if you didn't notice the large animal in front of me, this would be Hank. And I decided to do this video, as you can probably tell from the title or the description of my video, is what's Hank's story. I thought I'd share this with you guys because you guys are so sweet and so nice, and you leave such nice comments, and a lot of you have commented on Hank when he does appear in my videos. And I just think it's funny, like somebody thought he was my husband when I referred to the name Hank and stuff, and Hank is just such a big part of my life. And I think there's just a ton of animal lovers out there that they'd appreciate Hank's story. So I'll get started because it's kind of a long story, and it's kind of an honor to Hank because it's been 2 years next month that Hank has been a part of my life. So I'll start with, it was 2 years ago in February that I had decided to adopt a dog. I've had dogs in the past, but they've always been from breeders, and I had done some volunteer work at a local animal shelter and thought that those dogs were really, really sweet, and they really touched my heart, and they've been through a lot, and so I wanted to adopt a dog. I had never ever owned a German Shepherd. I've had Rottweilers, and I've had Labs, and I've had Chihuahuas and Terriers and a Fox Russell Terrier. I've had all those animals, but I've never had a German Shepherd. So at the time, 2 years ago, I was actually in a different relationship. You guys know I'm married now, but I was in a different relationship, and we had decided to adopt. It was, and I'll tell you this because it's kind of an important part of the story, that the relationship that I was in was, I like to call it a very tumultuous relationship, because we had been together for almost 5 years, and it was like an on again, off again, and we fought a lot in the relationship. And so I'm trying to get him in the shot too, because he's here too, so it's important that Hank's in the shot. So let me move over while he's in the shot. And so the relationship was kind of tough. It was something that we were kind of in and out of, and I think we thought that the dog maybe would fix some things, even though it was a very much broken relationship. And so we had adopted Hank. I had put an application out, and thank goodness they do such a good job, because they really do a very big kind of deal about it. And thank goodness, because these animals go through so much. So when I had put in my application, they had called references that we had posted, and this lady called and said, "We have a dog, and if you're interested, come and check him out." So I had seen other dogs and other German Shepherds, and to be honest with you, it was a breed that was unknown to me, and a lot of the dogs were, I think, very fearful of humans, and they tended to kind of snap every time we went to go meet them. Well, Hank was different. When we went to go see Hank, the lady said that he was so severely abused that he was actually what they had called a pancake dog. So if you don't know what a pancake dog is, a lot of the Michael Vick dogs were pancake dogs. They were so severely abused that they actually pancake themselves down to the ground when humans are around, and they never really stand up fully. So Hank happened to be one of those dogs. He was fairly severely beaten, and it's hard for me to say this story because it just tears me apart. But he unfortunately was abused, and came from another state, so they had brought him up to the state where I live in. And so when I went to go see him, he was so afraid of humans that he literally pancaked himself flat to the ground, hid behind a table, and I couldn't even get near him. The lady said, you know, she saw a lot of potential in him, but she said, you know, I haven't seen him be aggressive or anything like that. And for whatever reason, Hank just won me over. He didn't like come up to me and lick me. He didn't do anything like that. He was actually very, very fearful. He was underweight. He was about 72 pounds, and now he is about 87 pounds, so he's a lot heavier now. He had fleas, ticks, worms, and just severely, severely did not trust humans. So we brought him home, and that first night he just kind of kept his distance. He wasn't anywhere near us. The second day I decided to sit myself down on the ground, and I'll never forget, I mean, he is a pretty big guy. So when I sit on the ground and he stands, as you'll see, he almost kind of did that on command, right? He's big. And so he actually came up to me that second day, and his snout was right next to my face right here, and he licked me. And from that point on, Hank has touched me so much because it was kind of like an understanding, like, thank you, and I will trust you. And that's kind of how it's always been. He really, really started to progress a lot. Like, Hank had never been on a leash before. He actually got beat with a leash. So anytime I brought a leash near him, he would start to cower down, and he thought I was going to hit him with it. Now is the opposite. He's totally learned that a leash means a walk, and he is ready to go. And so the reason why I had mentioned to you guys the relationship that I was in at the time was because in that relationship, Hank had really kind of gravitated towards me and really warmed up to me and listened. I was able to teach him tricks, teach him how to go on a leash, and he very, very much responded to me and did really well. Unfortunately, the person that I was dating at the time did not take well to that. And so one day I had come home from work, and Hank came running over to me, and I walked into a back bedroom where the person I was dating at the time was sitting on the corner of the bed. And I said, "What's wrong?" He was looking kind of down at the ground, and he said, "I don't think it's going to work out with Hank." And my heart just sank. I mean, this guy had come from such a long way. He had a food allergy, so he really could not keep any food in. He had a rash on his entire underside because he was allergic to the food. I had picked ticks off of him. He had one on his snout. We'd done so much work, and he had come such a long way that I just couldn't process why someone would say that it's just not working out with him. He was potty trained. He never chews anything. In fact, Hank will not take anything unless you give him permission. So I can literally have a bone on the ground, and if I don't hand it to him, he won't take it. He won't touch it. So, I mean, he's a pretty spectacular dog, and he's really a wonderful rescue. And so it really, it shocked me at the time, to be honest with you. So I looked at him and I said, "I really don't understand why you don't think this is working out." And he just said, "My dog is going to obey me, not you." And had a lot of other mean stuff to say that I don't really want to say about it. But the moment that I realized that I need to move on from this relationship and get rid of it forever was when Hank rolled over right in front of him. And he looked right smack into that dog's face and said, "You're going to have to learn new tricks, buddy, if you want to stick around here." That weekend, I knew that it was a wrong relationship to be in. Anyone who says that to a rescue has come that long. And you guys, I don't want to get into it, but there was a lot of stuff that happened in our relationship that you can probably imagine from someone saying that to a rescue how that was. I left. I left, and Hank and I were on our own. And I attribute a lot of that to Hank. He had really opened my eyes to something that I think I didn't have my eyes open to. He truly is something that gives me joy in my life. And he gives me like hope. Every time I feel bad, I think about him and the things that he went through. And he's just such an amazing creature. Like, he's just such a good dog, you guys. Like, I wish you guys could know him, and I wish you could see what he looked like then and what he looks like now. But after leaving the person I was with, I went on my own. Hank and I had a wonderful time. He was a great, great roommate. I shortly thereafter met my husband, the person that I married now. And Nick, my husband, loves Hank, and they get along great. He takes Hank all the time. On a skateboard. So Nick actually goes on a skateboard, and him and Hank go off on their skateboard. So he's just an amazing dog, and I just want to let you guys know that story because he comes in my videos, and I will mention him because he is just, he means so much to me. He just came such a long way. I'll put some pictures in for you guys so you guys can see what he looked like before, but he really, truly, it's remarkable that people want to hurt animals that are as beautiful as Hank is. They just do really sick things to animals. And Hank is a purebred German Shepherd that I got for about $150. He was unwanted. He was hurt, and he is probably the best thing that has ever happened to me. I just love him so much, and he just means the world to me. And I'm glad that he found me, and I'm sure he's glad that I found him. And I'm going to see if he can get his little cute face in here. Hank, look at the camera. he didn't like the camera. So I just wanted to share that with you guys, because being as that I'll probably mention him again and again, I just want to let you guys know how important Hank is to me. And I think it's important also to rescue pets. So if you guys think about it, I can't say how great of a dog he truly is. I really truly believe when people say that rescues know that they were rescued, he 100% knows that he was rescued. I've never met a dog that is so grateful for just pets and love, and that's all he wanted, and that's mostly what all animals want from us. And Hank is like not even treat oriented, so he won't do things for treats. He'll do them for a good boy or a pat on the head or just any kind of signs of affection. He really actually responds to that better than any kind of treat or toy or anything like that. So he really is a sweet dog. He's never made a mess in our house. He's never chewed anything. He's never taken anything that's not his. He truly, honestly is just an amazing dog. It'll be 2 years, like I said, this February, and he really changed my life, because if it wasn't for him, I don't know where I'd be. I don't know if I'd be married to the person that I'm married to. Who knows if I would have still tried to make that other relationship work. That was just bad. It was very bad. So I kind of say that he was kind of the light that showed me the way. I like to think of Hank that way, and it may be silly that I think that, but I really do. I kind of attribute a lot of that to him. I attribute my strength to him to walk away from a 5-year relationship who I lived with that person, and I had to pack my stuff and go and find another place. But for some reason, I did it for him. I wanted Hank to have a good home. I didn't want him to not be in a good home. So now he has a great home. He has a huge yard to run around in. We spoil him like crazy, and we love him. I still keep in touch with the lady who I adopted him from. I send her a Christmas card of Hank every year, and she says that he looks great and that he should be a calendar dog, a dog that is shown in calendars. I think he's that good looking too, but he is my dog. So that's a Hank story, and I wanted to share that with you guys. So I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.
When the sky is falling from above you, and the wind is raging from the coast, and you want someone who truly loves you, I will be the one who loves you the most. Yes. When the masquerades and burlesque balls.
Cute. Hank, what are you doing? You got snow on your little face. He's so silly. He loves it. Look at him. He's such a goof. What a goof. What are you doing? This is your first snowfall here at home. Yeah, buddy. Go get him. Go get him.
Uh-oh, potty break.
There he is! Like lightning speed. OMG. Snow. God.